Hello, and now welcome to our second session now, in which we are going to first understand what this augmented reality really means. If you take the technical definition of augmented reality, we say that augmented reality is a technology that superimposes computer-generated images on a user's view of the real world, thus providing a composite view. That is, say for example, as the example we are showing here, if you have a room, you want to know how this room will look when you place a sofa. So we are going to take the 3D model of the sofa, and when we hold that image in our phone with this app, we can place the sofa virtually in our phone and check it how actually it will look after we place the sofa. So this is an example of augmented reality. So here, now the definition of augment in augmented reality, if we say augment, the meaning of augment is to add something. So if this is the actually the English, that is the meaning of the word augment. And whenever we do this augmented reality, when we use these softwares, we use a camera to take the real picture. And in the real picture, the computer will identify the geometry of this real picture. And based on the geometry, it is going to place our virtual image, that is a model, on that real picture. And we are going to see the composite view. So technically speaking, the definition of augmented reality is technology that superimposes computer-generated images on a live view of the real world captured through a camera, thus creating a composite view. This is the actual definition. Now, to see this augmented reality, the basic requirement is we need a good mobile device, that is a mobile phone with the camera, and it should have a good graphic display. That is, we should have a mobile phone with a good graphic display and camera. This is one type of setup which we usually use. But in case of professional augmented reality setups, which are highly expensive and which are still in the development stages, they use headsets like Microsoft HoloLens, Meta 2, or even Lenovo Mirage, Oculus Rift, and Oculus Quest also have cameras built in it to experience augmented reality. So the device HoloLens, this technology is being developed by Microsoft. It is currently very expensive. A HoloLens will cost you around 2,50,000 rupees. So this is a kind of projection based augmented reality, which we are going to discuss it later. We have another kind of augmented reality headset, which is called as Meta 2. And this is also currently expensive. It costs around 1 lakh rupees. And currently the cheapest augmented reality device is the Sony PSVR headset, which comes with the Sony, that is the PlayStation. So with Sony PlayStation 4, you get this Sony PSVR headset with camera. So this is currently used basically for playing games. And we cannot really call this as an augmented reality device, but this is an entertainment device which also can be used for some augmented reality purposes. We have other devices like HTC Vive and Oculus Rift, which has camera built into the headset. Here, you doesn't need a mobile phone. This headset itself will have the display along with all the sensors. So this kind of setup, Rift will cost around 80,000 rupees and HTC Vive will cost around 65,000 rupees. Basically, for augmented reality, when you are using your mobile, the basic requirements that you need in a mobile is, you should first compulsorily have a camera, then you should have GPS, and then you should have a sensor called accelerometer. This is actually going to judge the X, Y, and Z axis of the phone. That is, it determines whether your phone is held in landscape or portrait mode. And also, we need a magnetic compass to measure the magnetic field. Apart from this, the mobile should have good CPU, GPU, and also RAM. Now, if you come to types of augmented reality, we have four types of augmented reality. Marker-based augmented reality, marker-less augmented reality, projection-based augmented reality, and superimposed augmented reality. So in this, the first kind of augmented reality is marker-based. Marker-based means here, we are going to create, that is a marker. That is, marker means we are going to add a reference image in the app, so that when the camera sees that reference image, immediately the model will be triggered. Say for example, if you take a hotel menu, that is if you take a hotel menu card, if you have augmented reality, when you hold your mobile against the menu item or the menu image, automatically a 3D model of that menu will pop up and it will show it to you. So this is some example of this marker-based augmented reality. The second type of augmented reality is, this is the second type of augmented reality where marker-less means here it is going to judge the geometry of the scene. Say for example, when you project an image, it is going to identify the surfaces and based on the surface, that is based on the plane, you can place your object over the background image. So you can place it, and this is called as markerless, because on any image you can generate a 3D image and you can use it. So this is the second type of augmented reality. After this, the third type of marker, that is the another example for markerless augmented reality is actually this Pokemon Go game. You might have played it. On the real image, you will have a Pokemon cartoon appearing, and it is based on GPS. When you actually go and reach a particular location, automatically based on the GPS, at that location the Pokemon gets popped up. So this is a very good example for markerless augmented reality, Pokemon Go game. So after this, the third type of augmented reality is projection based augmented reality. Like previously we saw the HoloLens, we then also saw the Meta 2 and Google Glass. So in these cases what happens is, these lens here, that is the headsets, will have a mini projector built into it. So what happens is, when you are seeing the real picture through the eyes, the projector here projects a small image through a prism, and that image is superimposed over the real image that we are seeing. Say for example, when you go to a particular location, if you have Google Glass, it will automatically pop up the weather conditions there. When you are traveling, it will automatically show you the map on your eyes, that is on your glasses. So these kind of augmented reality, we call it as projection based. And currently this kind of augmented reality technology is in development, and it is very expensive right now. And after this, we have superimposition based augmented reality. So if you consider superimposition based augmented reality, here we are going to take an image, real image. Say for example, you can see here, say for example, you want to create a oil pipeline or you want to create some electrical wiring, so then what you can do is you can actually take the real image, and on that real image you can redraw your model based on the background image. So you can see here, say for example I want to connect this water tap, so then I can place the water tap manually here and I can just sync it and I can see how it really looks when I connect it, see, like this. You can manually collect this, and this kind of job we call it as superimposed augmented reality. So these are the four kinds of augmented reality that we are seeing. This completes our explanation about augmented reality, and in our next session we are going to discuss about virtual reality.